हेलो एवरीबॉडी, गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे आई वेलकम यू अगेन फॉर अनदर वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल दैट इज अबाउट पी बॉडी। टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द चेंजेस इन फिजिकल कंडीशन, फिजियोलॉजिकल कंडीशन, हार्मोनल लेवल ऑफ द बॉडी ड्यूरिंग पी बॉडी। लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रोसेस ऑफ पी बॉडी deals with some physical, physiological, hormonal changes along with psychological changes. After all these changes, the individual entering into the process of puberty became sexually matured individual. This sexually matured individual able to enter through the process of sexual reproduction. It is initiated by hormonal signal. The whole events of changes are regulated by brain, that is the hypothalamus brings or it provides signal to the gonad by different hormone. Today we will be discussing about various categories of hormone, their role in the process of puberty. Okay, the gonad produces hormone which induces the process of different type process of gamete formation along with various physical or physiological changes, such as the changes in muscular level, changes in bone, changes in skin, changes in hair growth, etc. Everything changes. The sexual dimorphism is also seen in different individual, male and female. Okay, then comes to the time period of puberty. What is the real time of puberty? Okay, it is found that in case of girls, it appeared at the age of 10 to 11 years and the process became completed between 15 to 17. In case of boys, it is slightly delayed. Okay, in boys, it starts at the age of 11 to 12 years and continues up to 16 to 17 years. Okay, it is happening in boys. The changes in climate may also affect, has certain impact on it. As we know, in cold climate, it is delayed. That means the climate have an impact. Climate put impact on sexual maturity or puberty. Okay. Then the process of neurohormone. How the neurohormone gives signal for the process of puberty. Let's see. Okay, neurohormones are the important part from where the neurohormones are released. Neurohormones. Hormones. Okay. It is found that the important part related to puberty, as I have told you before, is hypothalamus. Okay, hypothalamus. The hypothalamus directs pituitary gland.
for this purpose. Directs pituitary gland along with adrenal, pituitary and adrenal for the process of puberty. Okay. Some regulations of the body systems also maintain puberty. Okay. Hence, the central nervous system is believed to be responsible for puberty. Hypothalamus produces gonadotropic releasing hormone. Okay. Gonadotropic releasing hormone from the anterior pituitary. When the gonadotropic releasing hormone is produced from the anterior pituitary, with the response of gonadotropic hormone, the anterior pituitary started producing it act on anterior pituitary. The anterior pituitary started producing luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. Okay, luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. When the level of LH and FSH rises, it act on LH act on male and female, FSH also act on male and female. It rises the level of testosterone in case of female, estradiol. In case of male, it produces testosterone level rises. These hormones induces certain changes resulting puberty. Okay, body changes. We have to discuss what are the major factors in puberty. Okay. It is found that arcuate nucleus. This arcuate nucleus produces the gonadotropic releasing hormone. Okay. The gonadotropic releasing hormone act on gonad for puberty. Arcuate hormone produces gonadotropic releasing hormone. It is the prime process. After this, some other hormones are also produced. The second hormone we will discuss, that is the KNDY neuron started producing kisipeptin and neurokinin. These two are also important hormone. What are this role of this hormone? This hormone help in releasing of GnRH, gonadotropic releasing hormone produced by arcuate nucleus, but it is released by the product of kindy neurons released, GnRH released. After release of these hormones, when these hormone released out, the GnRH, it act on gonadotrope cells of pituitary. Okay. When the gonadotrope cells are activated by gonadotropic releasing hormone, it started producing luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone simultaneously. Then what happened? Luteinizing hormone, as you know, it is a larger protein hormone. Luteinizing hormone is a larger protein hormone. It acts on Leydig cells of testis and theca cells of ovary to release the hormone. It act on Leydig cell. Leydig cells of testis and theca cells of ovary. Okay, it act on both male and female.
Let's do erase it.
The follicle stimulating hormone. What the role of follicle stimulating hormone? The follicle stimulating hormone, after its release from the gonadotrope cell, it act on FSH, act on the ovary and also on the testis. Ovarian follicle, directly it act on ovarian follicle and Sertoli cell. Follicle of ovary, then Sertoli cells of testis. Okay, the FSH act on Sertoli cell and follicular ovary, but LH act on Leydig cell and theca cells of ovary. Okay. Now, testosterone and estrogens are produced. Testosterone and estrogens are produced from male and female. This induces puberty. This induces puberty. Okay. Like this hormone, it is found that adrenal androgen. This is all about the hormonal control of puberty. Okay. Then in puberty, it is found that the role of adrenal hormones. The adrenal hormones has specific role. As you know, the fetal zone of adrenal gland produces dihydroepiandrogen. It is one of the adrenal androgen. It is also believed to cause puberty. Okay. Then another hormone, that is IGF-1. Then another hormone, that is leptin. The IGF-1 induces puberty growth. All type of growth of body during puberty is due to it. The leptin, which is produced from the connective tissue, it regulates appetite and energy during puberty. Okay. After all sorts of hormonal stimulation, puberty appeared in organism. Okay. After onset of puberty by this hormonal factor, after the induction of puberty, changes appeared in male and female. Then come to changes in male and in female. Okay. If we compare, it is found that secondary sexual character growth is common in both cases. Growth female, they also grows during the puberty. The ability of erection found in male, ability of erection. The second one is pubic hair. Body growth, pubic hair, it is also found in female, pubic hair. There is a change in voice in male and also in female. There are some psychological changes in psychology. Here also psychological changes. Secondary sexual characters, beard, mustache, these have developed in male. In case of female, mammary glands enlarge, mammary glands develop, body odor changes in case of female, the pheromone level rises, hair below the arm hair appeared in female. Okay, the Adam's apple in male became prominent. Adam's apple became prominent during the puberty growth. Okay, these are the different type of changes which induced after puberty. Okay, this is all about the hormonal induction of puberty and different type of changes in male and female resulting sexual dimorphism. Okay, thank you all again.